Today we will start a new region, which is lower limb. First of all, we will discuss the lower limb regions. The lower limbs are the extensions from the trunk specialized to support the body weight. They are for locomotion and to maintain the balance. You can see in this diagram, this is lower limb. Lower limb is the inferior appendicular skeleton. Just like the upper limb, which is superior appendicular skeleton, they are united with the axial skeleton. There are two lower limbs on each side, which is connected to the trunk. They are specialized to support the body weight. They are for locomotion and to maintain the balance. These are the bones which are forming the lower limb. We will discuss the lower limb regions one by one. First of all, I will tell you that there are six major regions of the lower limb. The first region is called as gluteal region. The word glutos means buttocks. It is the transitional region between the trunk and the free lower limb. You can see here in this diagram, this is the gluteal region. It is the region which is in between the trunk, because trunk will be the upper body, and it is in between the trunk and the lower limb free bones. Okay, it includes two parts of the lower limb. The first part, which is the rounded one, and it is prominent posterior region, this is called as buttocks. Okay, or it is also called as the Latin word nates or clones. And the lateral part, you can see here, this lateral part, which is less prominent, is called as hip region. Hip word comes from the hip bone, and it is a Latin word which comes from the coxae, which overlies the hip joint and the greater trochanter of the femur. So what we have learned, the gluteal region, it consists of two parts. The first part is the most prominent region, which is because of this muscle, which is gluteus maximus muscle. This is called as buttocks. And the less prominent, the lateral region, is called as hip region, which is because of the hip joint or the greater trochanter of the femur. So this is the first region, the gluteal region, having two parts, the buttocks and the hip region. See in this diagram also, this is gluteal region. Okay, this is, there will be the greater trochanter of the femur, and there will be hip bone. They are forming the lateral part, and the most posterior part, which is the most prominent part, is called as the buttocks. Now the second region, the femoral region or the thigh. See here in this diagram, this region, which is the upper part of the lower limb, is called as the thigh region or the femoral region. It is the region of the free lower limb that lies between the gluteal. See here, gluteal is the buttock part, and the abdominal, you know, the abdominal region, and the perineal region. Perineal region is the lower region in which all the urinary organs and the reproductive organs are present. So this is the region. The femoral region is a region which is in between the gluteal, abdominal and perineal regions proximally, and the knee joint or knee region distally. Proximally, which is more closer to the body, and distally, which is away from the midline of the body. So this is a thigh region or the femoral region. It includes most of the femur. The femur is the thigh bone. It is the most, you can say, heaviest bone of our body. The transition from trunk to the free lower limb occurs abruptly in the region of the inguinal part, or the inguinal region, or the groin. This is called as groin, where I'm showing my cursor. This is groin or the inguinal region. So what we have learned? We have learned that this is the femoral region, which is the thigh region. Number three is the knee region. Knee words comes, or knee is a word which is derived from a Latin word genus. Okay, wherever the word genus or genu is written, it means knee joint or the knee region. It includes the prominences or the condyles of the distal femur. You can see in this diagram, this is femur bone or the thigh bone. It has two condyles at the lower end, which is medial condyle and the lateral condyle. And this knee region includes both condyles of femur and the condyles of proximal tibia. See here, this is the proximal part of the tibia, the head of the fibula, and the patella. This is patella bone, which is also called as the kneecap. These are the bones or parts which are included in the knee region. Okay, they are forming the knee joint, which is also included in the knee region. The posterior region of the knee, which is also called as the popliteus, it includes a well-defined, fat-filled hollow transmitting neurovascular structures. This fossa or this space is called as popliteal space. Again, I will describe you this diagram. See here, this is femur bone. The below one, there are two bones, which are tibia and fibula. Tibia is the medial bone and the fibula is the lateral bone. And anteriorly, we have a small kneecap which is called as patella, which will show that this is the anterior part and behind this is the posterior part. On the posterior side, there is a small space which is fat filled and having the neurovascular structures. This space is called as the popliteal space or the popliteal fossa. So this is the third region, which is genu or the knee region. Now we comes toward the fourth region. This is leg region. You can see here. Can you see here in this diagram? This is called as leg. Okay. Often the layperson refer incorrectly to the entire lower limb as the leg, but it is wrong. Only the lower part of the lower limb is called as the leg, because the upper part of the lower limb is called as the thigh. So this is only leg, which comes from or which is from the knee region till the foot. This is called as leg. Okay. Wherever the word cruris is written or crura is written, it means it comes from the leg region, or it is derived from a word which is Latin. In Latin language, cruris. Okay, so it is, and regio is the region. So leg region is the cruris region. It is a part that lies between the knee. See here in the diagram, it lies between the knee and the narrow distal part of the leg. It includes most of the tibia. See here, this is tibia, which is the medial bone of the leg. This is also called as the shin bone, and the lateral bone, which is fibula, which is also called as the calf bone. The leg, the word Latin word crus, it connects the knee and the foot. Remember, the leg connects the knee joint with the ankle joint, okay, which is formed by the tibia and some of the bones of the foot. Okay, so remember, this is the fourth region, which is the leg region. Now we come towards the fifth region, that is the ankle. Can you see here? This is the ankle, which comes from a word tarsus or talocrural region. Why it is called as the talocrural? Crural is a word which is from the leg, and talo, it comes from a bone which is talus. See here, this is the bone of the foot which is named as talus. Okay, so talocrural region. Talocrural region, or Latin word tarsus means ankle. Okay, it is a region which is talocruralis, includes the medial and the lateral prominences, which are called as medial malleolus and the lateral malleolus. Medial malleolus is of the tibia and lateral malleolus is of the fibula, and they flank the ankle joint, which is also called as the talocrural joint, because crural means leg and talo comes from the bone talus, which is the bone of the foot. So this is the fifth region, which is the ankle region. Now the sixth region, which is foot. Okay, a Latin word pes means foot or the foot region. Regio pedis. The word pedis means foot. It is the distal part of the lower limb containing many bones. Okay, the bones are tarsus, metatarsus, and phalangeal bones. See here, these bones are called as tarsal bones. Okay, just like carpal bones in our hand, we have the tarsal bones in the foot. Then we have the metatarsal bones, just like the metacarpal bones in the hand. And there are same phalanges, the 14 phalanges which are in the foot, just like 14 phalanges in the hand. Okay, so this is foot, which is pes or the foot region. It is the distal part of the lower limb containing the tarsus or tarsal bones, metatarsal bones, and the phalanges, which are also called as toe bones. The toes are the digits of the foot. The great toe, wherever the word hallux is written, it means the great toe or the big toe. Like the thumb has only two phalanges or two digital bones. The other digits have three phalanges. Okay, they have three phalanges, and only the hallux or the great toe has two phalanges. So there are total 14 phalanges in one foot or one foot. Okay. Now these were the six regions of the lower limb. Now the skeleton of the lower limb, which is also called as inferior appendicular skeleton, may be divided into two functional components. The first component is a pelvic girdle. Can you see this diagram? This is showing the pelvic girdle or the bony pelvis. It is a bony ring. It is composed of sacrum. See here, this is sacrum, which is the bone which is posterior, and the right hip bone and the left hip bone joined anteriorly at the pubic symphysis. See here, this is a joint which is called as pubic symphysis because it is a secondary cartilaginous joint. So what are the structures present in the pelvic girdle? Sacrum, coccyx, two hip bones on the lateral sides, and one joint which is called as pubic symphysis anteriorly. The pelvic girdle attaches the free lower limb to the axial skeleton. Axial skeleton consists of the vertebra and the sacrum. Okay. So sacrum is a part of axial skeleton as well as the appendicular skeleton. Okay, its protective and supportive functions serve the abdomen, pelvis and perineum as well as the lower limb. So pelvic girdle is the first functional part of the skeleton of the lower limb. Then we have the bones of the free lower limb. They are contained within and specifically that part of the limb. So these are the bones of the free lower limb. See here, I will again revise all the bones. This is sacrum. See, this is sacrum. This is coccyx. They are a part of the axial skeleton because axial skeleton consists of the cranium and all types of vertebra. 33 vertebra are there. Then we have sacrum and coccyx. Then we have appendicular skeleton. In the appendicular skeleton, we have the part of the pelvic girdle, which is hip bone. Then we have femur. This is patella. This is tibia. This is fibula. And there are many bones of the foot, which are in the foot region. There are tarsal bones, then metatarsal bones, and 14 phalanges are there. So first we have discussed that this is gluteal region, which consists of buttocks and hips. Then we have femoral region, which consists of thigh bone, which is femur. Then we have knee region, which consists of many bones, which are patella, the inferior end of the femur, the superior end of the tibia, or the proximal end of the tibia and fibula. Okay, this is knee region. Then we have the leg region having two bones, tibia, which is also called as shin bone, and fibula, which is also called as calf bone. Then we have the ankle region. In the ankle, we have the medial malleolus of the tibia and lateral malleolus of the fibula and the tarsal bones. Tarsal bone, which is talus, which is forming or which is contributing in the formation of ankle joint. So it is called as talocrural joint. Then we have the foot. Okay, we have phalanges in the foot. We have metatarsal bones and we have tarsal bones, okay, which include talus, calcaneum and many other bones are there. So we have discussed the lower limb region, in which we have learned the bones of the lower limb.